master data, there are four types of master data: customer master data, material master data, customer material info record, and condition record. So, in which the CMIR had the most priority. So, whenever you create a sales order, the system tried to take the values from CMIR if it exists. If not, it will come to the customer master and then take from the customer master as well as material master. Okay. Then we came to the sales activities. So we started with the sales document type customizing. In the sales document customizing, we saw the differences between the different document types, how a sales process is mapped using the document type. Okay. Then we came to the item category. We saw how important an item category is in the sales order, how it controls the items in the sales order. For example, like how on what basis the same article is being determined as TAN or TANN or TAS, whatever it could be. So we saw how it is being determined. The determination rule is like sales document type plus item category group plus usage plus higher level item category gives the item category. Okay. So then these are about the schedule and category. So how schedule and categories influence in the delivery as well as carrying out the availability check, and how these schedule and categories are instrumental in sales to production and procurement. Okay. Then we came to the basic function. Basic functions we started with incompletion log. So how certain things, I mean, so if certain things are not filled, how to deem the document as incomplete, and what are the choices we had in this? So we had either to stop saving the document, or we can save an incomplete document which cannot be processed further. So we created the status group. We created the procedures, we created we assigned those procedures to the sales document type, and not only in the sales document type, the incompletion procedures were assigned to the item categories, customer master and everything. Then we came to the partner determination. In the partner determination, we saw how the system take partners. For example, like we had different ship to party, different sold to, I mean, different bill to party payers, but there was only one sold to party, and we cannot, and we even saw why or how we were not able to add more sold to parties. Okay. And these are some functionalities like adding new partners to the customer master, like employee responsible, credit representative group. Okay. And we defined the additional partners in our sales document type, which means the sales document type deliveries and billing, which means if you want the credit representative group to be flowed in the billing document, which means like tomorrow when you want to analyze the performance of the credit representative group, how many billing documents he has handled, so those kind of things, how it has to flow. So we had, as usual, we had defined a procedure, and we had assigned the partner functionality to that procedure. Then the procedure was added to the document type. For customer level, we added to the account groups. For item level, we assigned it to the item category. Then what we saw? So we started with log of incomplete term, then we went to partner determination. Okay. Then we saw about the pricing. We started with the pricing because we wanted to know about the condition technique. So we learned how in condition technique is because. Okay, so what are the steps? First we created the condition table, then assigned those condition tables to the access sequence. That access sequence is assigned to the condition type. The condition types were placed in the procedures. Okay. Then for certain combinations, for example, for pricing procedure, so we had the combination of sales area plus customer pricing procedure plus document pricing procedure. Okay, so the system determined the pricing procedure based on these combinations. Okay. So Sirisha had created a document type at that day. So we used her document type to check the functionality of pricing procedure determination by using this combination. Okay. Then based on the condition technique, we saw about the free goods determination. Then we saw the material determination. Okay. Then we had the listing and exclusion. Okay. Then I think we are done with. Okay. So we had seen all these things in our sales activities. So now we have to move towards the distribution. Okay. How familiar you people are with the sales order cycle, that is creating the sales order, delivery, and then up to billing. Pardon? You are comfortable. Okay, there's someone. Had somebody called? Yeah. I think Sirisha is joining. No, not necessary. Order, delivery, and billing. Okay, now I'm just creating one. Okay. So I'm creating a sales order cycle. Ten pieces. All exclusion is being maintained. Slash and VB. Okay. Yeah, that's the problem. Session A0. Okay, so my delivery date is on 18th and from the plant 1200. So, till now what we had seen, so we have seen, we had created a sales order, then we go to the menu path of creating that, the delivery. Okay, then once it is done, we went to the billing part of that. Okay, instead we can use the, which means when you are handling the individual documents, you can use the, you can shortcut like, you can go to the deliver directly from here. Okay. So, which means like the system automatically save the sales order and will take you to the VL01 screen. Okay. But right now, our intention is, okay, in first, let me go to the item detail. Okay. Here, we can see the plant is taken as 1200. How does the system know that this article has to be taken from the plant 1200. Any idea? Partially right. how come? It has to check the plant for availability. It's not the other way around. When you say like, if you want to say like, okay, let me check whether an article is available, where you will check? You will check on a particular place, not particular plant, okay? So the availability check is based on the plant determined, not the plant is not determined based on availability check. It's the other way around. Okay. First, the system looks for the data from customer master info record. So let me do one thing. Slash OBD51. That is creating the info record. CH8101. Test material. Here you can see the plant. Okay, the system like I had told some time back, the system always looks at the CMIR for the data first. The data entered in the CMIR has the most priority over any other master data. Okay, so it checks for the plant here, delivery priority here. Even though the delivery priority given here is different from the delivery priority in the customer master, the system will take the one given in the CMIR. Okay. So, going by that, like in your system, customer master, everything is so